Hello and good morning, guys. You can see the clock behind me. It's what, 11:20? 11:25. I have been up all day, okay? By that, I mean dark 30 is when I got up. I have never in my adult life yard sale, okay? I'm talking about have a yard sale, okay? When I was in high school, oh, my friends are here. Guys, I'll have to come back. But long story short, I got rained out of my yard sale. This is why I don't yard sale. It's pouring the rain. My friends are here. I'll be back later, guys. Okay, I'm back from earlier. What I was trying to tell y'all before my friends came over, I have never, as an adult, done a yard sale. I've never had a yard sale. I love to yard sale, you know, but that is usually me going and buying something. I'm just not someone who sells something. Like, I hate selling things. I'm not a salesperson. So, I thought my neighbor was like, Erica, come on. You got all these clothes. Your closet just fell. You just redid your closet. Come on and, you know, do this yard sale. Because our neighborhood has, like, a couple of yard sales a year. Honey, I set up, went through, I mean, I'm talking washed, dried, hung up all these clothes because I can't stand the thoughts of like giving somebody something that's been hanging and, you know, like not freshly laundered. So I worked so hard, got everything set up, was out in my driveway at 6:30 a.m. It rained us out. It rained us out. I said, y'all would have had a good yard sale if I was not involved. It's because I was part of it. So anywho, little bit of a fail, but it's okay. So I've got everything like in the garage. If you can see, I did empty one clothing rack, but I squished like this one over here. That one's full of nursing scrubs. And then I've got one like right here. So whatever, it's fine. We'll figure out like what to do with it at some point. But I actually just got back from the pharmacy. I had my COVID-19 booster today. So a lot of rules in Kentucky were passed this following week regarding, like, I guess people who are 65 years of age and older are eligible for a booster. But because I had my vaccine series in March, but if you have a compromised immune system, I have an autoimmune disease. I have Hashimoto's, so I am considered immune compromised. Then I meet criteria now to get my booster. So I went and had it. I'm trying to prevent getting sick. I do what I can for my own health, you know, and I think it's something you just have to decide for you. But feeling good, feeling totally normal. So one of my friends actually sent me a recipe. My friend Sandra, who's on here. Hi, Sandra. let me put you down here. But she sent me a recipe this morning and I guess had thought of me when she seen it. And I was like, no lie. I have already had the recipe set aside to make this weekend. So I forgot that I didn't have cream of tartar. I had to run to the grocery store just now. That's where the pharmacy was, where I got my shot. My camera holder, I'm gonna have to replace it, dude. Okay, but I'm gonna make a cake today. It is a salted caramel Kentucky butter cake. I've born and raised, still live in Kentucky, and have never heard of a Kentucky butter cake. But honey, we're gonna make one today. I'm gonna make it a different video, just so, you know, in case watching me cook is not your thing, my camera is gonna fall over. Then you don't have to watch me preparing it. So anywho, I will show you all that, see how it turns out. It is a bundt cake. I love a bundt cake. It's one of my favorite kinds of cakes because I'm not really a person who likes a lot of thick, heavy frosting and icing. So I think it'll be so good. But anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and get to cooking and I'll check in a little while, guys. I don't know if I'll check in on this vlog video today, but I'll check in the next couple of days. Maybe I'll check in tomorrow and show you what I'm wearing to church, okay? So anyways, I'll check in later, guys. Bye. Hello and good morning. Guys, I've done it again. I ordered me another set of nails on Amazon. I think these look really pretty. These are supposed to be short stiletto nails. You can actually see my real nail under there. I have long nails, but There's just, I think these are more almond, if I do say so myself, but this is a very workable length so far for me. I wanted to show you these nails in case you are into, you know, fake nails. I'm so not. I'm much more a natural nail person, but there's just something I find so attractive about this. And I really like this nude, kind of not pink, not white, just kind of their nail. Anywho, I found a couple different kinds of nails on Amazon. So these, you get 30 manicures in here, okay? Lots of different colors. I'm supposed to go tailgating to the UK and Florida game October 2nd, so I think I might wear these. But in this, you get a lot of these, like, kind of nude, like, barely pink, off-white, white, you know, like, this is it like a pale gray. I love that these are already painted, you know, and that's very handy. There's not a color in here I wouldn't wear. So I love this like robin's egg blue. I would even wear this like at Halloween, this kind of lime green. I think it's really cute. Again, I would wear the orange at Halloween. And then just a lot of pretty brights for like spring and summer. Lots of nudes, and then, you know, bright reds. Then you get into these like dark, vampy fall and winter seasons, you know. I think these would be like more safer fall. And then, you know, the reds and deeper reds, maybe that like dark green for, you know, winter, like Christmas time. So I think these are really pretty. I definitely would consider this myself more of like an almond shape, because it's not that definite stiletto point, which is actually what I wanted. I really enjoy that look of that stiletto nail. So that being said, let me get all these stacked up. I'll put the price here on the screen, but basically one of these strips is going to do you a manicure, because you know you're going to use your sizes and you're not going to be able to do more than one set if your fingers are different sizes like mine. So I mean, I basically use the smallest ones. My nail beds are very petite, but I'm gonna leave this blue right here on top because I think I'm gonna wear this to the tailgating game. That should be, I mean, I'm hoping these will last a couple of weeks. We'll see. Okay, I'll let you know. I'll let you know if I'm able to still wear them. But then I got these. These had such good reviews. I mean, they had fabulous reviews. And I started to go ahead and use these this morning just to try them out, because they're one of the ones I'm most excited to try. This is a true stiletto shape. Let me get a bigger size nail. Here we go. The zero. This is the biggest one they have. But these are clear. And the only reason I went this route, even though it's a longer nail, and even though it's more of an almond shape, when I really did want, you know, stiletto, I used it because these are clear and I would have to paint them. So that's what that nail looks like, if you can see it. It's definitely, I mean, that's too big for my nail. I mean, this is too big for my nail, but if you can see, it's definitely a stiletto shape. It's way more pointy. Not way more. I guess it's kind of, I don't know. But these have beautiful reviews, and you can get them in a various, you know, various lengths, things like that, and also different shapes. But, and I really did want to try them. But you can't deny the handiness of already having these painted. So we'll see how these work. I'll let you know. The only thing that I've seen that people tended to complain about with these was that they lost their shininess after a few days. So I may just go ahead and seal mine with like a coat of Sesh Veet just to, you know, keep the glossiness on there. And if I see it's wearing off, honey, I'll just slap it clear coat on it. I'm not really hard to please, but very cheap. 30 different colors of manicures. I think this color set is gorgeous. So many of these kind of nudie pink shades. Great colors for the fall and winter, and then also your pretty brights for spring and summer. So I'll let you see how these work out. I'm gonna go work. Bye guys. All right, guys, so I mentioned how I drink my tea with my collagen. I just thought I would show you how I do it. So this tea has been brewing for, you know, a couple minutes. This is the Bigelow Earl Grey, okay? So the first thing I do is I just kind of take the back of a spoon and squish out what I can from the tea bag. And then I set this aside, and I'm going to drop it back in my tea just in the event that there's any more that I can brew out of that, okay? All right. First thing I do is I take 2 packets of stevia. This is stevia in the raw. This is the best for drinks that I have found. It does not taste like dirt. Most of the time, stevia tastes like dirt to me. That one tastes so good. You would never know. You don't have sugar. I mean, it's so, so good. All right, and then the collagen that I've been using. I mentioned in my last video that I love the Vital Proteins. I'm not much for the marine collagen just because, I don't know, there's something that grosses me out thinking that this is made from fish, but it doesn't taste fishy. I don't want you to think that. I'm just going to stick with the regular. I have repurchased the regular, but I'm not going to waste my money. I've still got like that much left of the marine collagen. So I'm going to finish it just to be, you know, I spent my money on it. I need to go ahead and use it. And that is it. The mint flavor of kind of like the Earl Grey. The Earl Grey tea is kind of strong. And it, I don't know, the collagen powder just makes it really creamy and good. I think I am going to add a dash of half and half to this today just because I like my collagen tea to be kind of creamy. So I'm just going to use a little bit of half and half, and truly just a little, like that much, literally just a swig, and mix-a-roo. Then after all that's mixed up and incorporated, I just kind of drop my little tea bag back down in it and let it finish brewing. Guys, so good. Best way I have found to drink my collagen powder.